In these uncertain economic times, you've got to do whatever you can to save money. One of our biggest expenses can be our cars, especially when unexpected repair bills hit. Not anymore. If you own a vehicle with less than 130,000 miles, is less than 12 years old, has a warranty about to expire, or even no warranty at all, you could stop paying for car repairs. Roadside assistance, towing, and rental coverage are all included. Don't wait for the next repair. Make one free call right now to see if you qualify. If your vehicle is less than 12 years old, has less than 130,000 miles, even if it's out of warranty, paying for car repairs can become a thing of the past. Call us right now and get your car protected before your next repair bill hits. Get protection and no more repair bills. Call 800-696-1030. Again, 800-696-1030. That's 800-696-1030. 800-696-1030.
All right, folks, this is Rick Robinson with you. I want to tell you about some friends of mine from a company called Security Enforcement Specialists. When I ran my security agency for 12 years, I worked with one of these partners on a daily basis. He's been involved in this agency now, and with his other partner, they do have over 30 years of experience in the private security industry. If you own a business and you need someone to keep you or your customers or residents safe, then I highly recommend contacting Security Enforcement Specialists today. Give them a call at 405-703-1796. Again, that's 405-703-1796. Again, tell them Rick from K98 Talk sent you. Like I said, if you need the help, they are here for you. So make sure that you go look them up, check them out, and see what they can do. The wrong way. Welcome to the place.
Joe had huge problems with the IRS.
I knew it was coming. I hadn't filed taxes since 1990.
All the IRS letters coming in added up to a nightmare.
To get up to like $68,000, my heart started beating fast. It's like, there's no way, man. I mean, I ain't gonna be able to do this.
Then they stopped his paycheck.
So that's when I started making phone calls and found U.S. Tax Shield.
U.S. Tax Shield went to work immediately.
They just took the bull by the horns. What blew my mind is he called the IRS right then and there.
So why is U.S. Tax Shield A-plus rated with the Better Business Bureau? Joe knows.
They saved me a ridiculous amount of money.
If you owe more than $10,000 to the IRS or state, choose the company Joe chose, U.S. Tax Shield.
It was the best decision I made. U.S. Tax Shield is the way to go. Life is good. Thank you, Lord.
Call 800-471-3287.
U.S. Tax Shield. Boo-rah. Yes.
800-471-3287. 800-471-3287.
The internet will never be the same. You're listening to K98Talk.com.
Whoa! Good God, y'all!
What is it good for?
From the East Coast to the West Coast and around the world on the internet, we're coming to you live from the CCRS studios, WNJC 1360. This is the Conservative Commandos Radio Show with your host, Rick Trader. The Conservative Commandos Radio Show, where the newsmakers go to be heard. You can call the Conservative Commandos Radio Show at 856-227-1360. Your opinion counts at 856-227-1360.
This is Congressman Alan West, and you're listening to the Conservative Commando Radio Show.
Welcome to the Conservative Commandos Radio Show with Anna Little and Rick Trader. And Anna is the patriot from the Garden State of New Jersey. Anna, welcome back to the Conservative Commandos Radio Show.
Glad to be with you, Rick.
You know what I've discovered, Anna? Works better when I turn the microphones on.
Well, that's of course true. But you know, when you're trying to single-handedly do all that you do, it is understandable that you might need a little time to do that.
Yeah, well, a little time is all it takes. Little time is
all
it takes.
That's right.
So, Anna, it's great to have you with us today. And what's on your radar screen this day, my friend?
Well, Well, you remember there's this ongoing saga with Planned Parenthood, and they did release yet another video, so I think it's worth discussing. It's the sixth shocking video, which has now caught Planned Parenthood selling aborted babies, this time without the patient consent, the patient in this case being the mother. So it appears that whatever tissue donors want, they get when they're working with Planned Parenthood. And this is something that I think really needs to be further explored and discussed, because I don't believe the majority of Americans would be in support of this, and yet taxpayer dollars fund it.
And I just had a thought. Let me run this thought by you. You know, I'm not a lawsuit crazy person. In fact, we have Bob Dorigo Jones on about every month talking about crazy, frivolous lawsuits. But I just had a thought. Maybe this is a way to finally put Planned Parenthood out of business. If we could find out who these women are who have had abortions, whose fetal tissue has been stolen from them and has been sold on the open market. There are a lot of women out there who regret their abortion. Maybe this is a way, if we can organize, or if someone could organize them, to go after Planned Parenthood legally and sue the pants off of them. Maybe that's a way to put them out of business.
Well, I don't even think people are thinking about putting them out of business.
I am.
Well, I hear you. But I think what Congress is trying to do is just take away the taxpayer funding, which I think is appropriate because it is actually a profitable business, and they're talking about profit in these videos. So it does seem appropriate to have the taxpayer funding that is supporting an already profitable organization. And I think when framed in that way, the majority of Americans agree.
Well, I agree with you, Anna. Great. Let's take away the taxpayer funding from them. But the other thing is, let's put these people out of business. It's a bad, very bad company. It's a very bad organization that commits murder. Why wouldn't we want to put them out of business once and for all?
Well, I agree. So I think it's very important that we stay on this topic, Rick, because you know what happens is you have the first explosive video, and then people start to chatter about it, and then the next one comes out, and then you have the judge trying to stop the third, and then the third and the fourth do make it out, and the fifth, and by now the media is on to something else, and people tend to forget. And you know, you have to remember to check out all your pro-life websites, but also check out the Center for Medical Progress, and do support that organization, because if it were not for the Center for Medical Progress, we wouldn't have any of these expose videos. And it's important that the American people know where their money's being spent, and that women and children be protected to the fullest extent of the law. Mm-hmm. And this tissue donor, the laws with regard to tissue donor organizations and the procurement of that, and the money that changes hands, the laws are being broken by both the tissue donor organization and Planned Parenthood. And the rights of patients are being violated, and human organs, and in some cases, a lot of cases, entire human cadavers of very vulnerable members of our society, the unborn children, but their entire body being donated to science without any consent on the part of a guardian for that child. Not even the mother knows about it. And there's a profit being made by these two corporations, Planned Parenthood and the Tissue Donor Organization. So at this point, I think it is necessary not only to complete the congressional investigation, but to withdraw the taxpayer funding for two reasons. One, it's a profitable organization. Two, they're committing a crime. You don't fund organizations that commit crime or that break the law in any way. Mm-hmm. And then what we've got to do is prosecute those who are guilty of these crimes. And we've got those here on the videos and their names. So I don't see how they escape this kind of prosecution at this point. And then we've really got to talk about the abortion industry as a whole, but that's a final goal at the end, because there are obviously aspects of the abortion industry that need to be brought to light. And it's very important that abortion be seen by everyone for what it is. For too long, we've tried to call it women's health care. It's anything but women's health care. It's the killing of a healthy baby for no good reason. And that's what it is. And it harms women in the process. It's not easy. It's not a solution. It's a complete other set of problems. There's no woman that walks into an abortion or a killing center, an abortion facility, happy, and they leave in terrible pain. It is not a solution to a problem. And I think when we begin to really shed light on what an abortion is, how it's conducted, how women are treated in that process and in the aftermath, and then all of the calamities that occur because of the lack of attention given to the women, and then you put on top of it what's going on with the babies, oh my goodness, it's just a nightmare, the entire thing. I think the American people will see it for what it is. I think they will start by defunding it with their taxpayer dollars, and I think they will go one step further and start to regulate it in such a way that abortions will either be rare and few and rare, or they could actually make it illegal. Because once you accept that that unborn child is a human being, you cannot condone murder. Mm. Not in our way of life.
Anna, I wanted to get your opinion.
Technology is showing us these are human beings.
Anna, I wanted to get your opinion of a company called STEM Express.
Express.
They're a major fetal body parts buyer. By the way, they're cutting their ties with Planned Parenthood. But they are a major fetal body parts buyer. Do you think this is also a company that should come under people's scrutiny?
Absolutely. STEM Express is the one exposed in the sixth video, even more so than Planned Parenthood. Planned Parenthood gives STEM Express carte blanche in their facility to identify from a complete patient list who they want to target, and whether that yes or no, they take. STEM Express is more at fault in this last video than Planned Parenthood is. Planned Parenthood is at fault for allowing the patient list to be made available and giving carte blanche in their facility to STEM Express, but STEM Express is the one breaking the law, avoiding consent, breaking consent when they don't have it, when they have a negative, no, I don't want to donate my baby's tissue to science, and they take it anyway. And they are actually covering up the receipt of human cadavers in conspiracy with Planned Parenthood by listing them as line items instead of as the entire cadaver. So they're lying about what they're taking as far as tissue.
Terrible. What a world we live in, Anna, when we have to deal with companies that profit from baby parts. Hey, Anna, we're going to take our break, and you are listening to the Conservative Commandos radio show with Anna Little and yours truly, Rick Trader, coming to you live from the studio. Protected by the second, Anna and I will be right back. I really don't care. That's my prerogative. They say I'm nasty, but I.
The Conservative Commandos radio show is expanding to become the Conservative Commandos Radio Network. We are establishing a front line of conservative radio broadcasters and ironclad patriots to declare war against the madness of liberalism and the Obama administration. Are you tired of the disregard for our Constitution? Do you still have faith in the American dream? Are you looking for sensible, smart radio? If so, listen to the Conservative Commandos Radio Network every weekday from 11 a.m. to 7 p.m. and Saturdays from 2 to 6 p.m. on WNJC Radio, 1360 on your AM dial, or around the world on the internet at WNJCRadio.com. Check out our website, CCRSNetwork.com, for rebroadcasts and network updates. We are the Conservative Commandos Radio Network, where now even more newsmakers go to be heard.
Hi, this is Bob Vide, owner of Bob's Little Sports Shop in Glassboro, New Jersey. I've had the opportunity to travel in many foreign countries, and I've seen what happens to people when they lose their freedom. I wrote this poem. Give us freedom was the cry as they marched throughout the night at Concord Bridge in Trenton. For freedom they would fight. To build a nation that would last with peace and liberty, it is a job that's never done if we are to be free. They wrote a declaration to announce that we are free, then a constitution for all the world to see. But this is ink on paper. We must make it last. It must always be defended, and that is quite a task. Today the battle rages for freedom in our land. To save our constitution, we all must take a stand. We must stand up for freedom in our actions every day, and you can stand up with us. Join the NRA. This is Bob Vidin of Bob's Little Sports Shop in Glassboro, New Jersey. You may call us at area code 856-881-7575 or visit us online at bobslittlesportshop.com.
From the East Coast to the West Coast and around the world on the Internet, we're coming to you live from the CCRS studios, WNJC 1360. This is the Conservative Commandos radio show with your host, Rick Trader. The Conservative Commandos radio show, where the newsmakers go to be heard. Businessman there, to drink my wine. You can call the Conservative Commandos radio show at 856-227-1360. Your opinion counts at 856-227-1360.
This is Congressman Alan West, and you're listening to the Conservative Commando Radio Show.
Welcome back to the Conservative Commandos Radio Show with Anna Little and yours truly, Rick Trader. And before I go any further, I'm going to pledge to do my best, to do my absolute best, to have the microphone open. Isn't that a good thing? If you'd like to hear rebroadcasts of our shows, check out our websites, ccrshow.com or ccrsnetwork.com, or mornings at 9 a.m. Eastern, log on to leadingedgeradionetwork.com. You could also hear our show any time of the day from your telephone by calling 832-999-1199. Hey, let me put this call out there, Anna. We could use somebody to work with us here in the studio to push the buttons. No, that'd be great. Just to have somebody here in the studio push the buttons. Anna, before we go much further, why don't we tell our audience who our guests are today?
Well, in our first segment, we're going to be speaking with Roger Beckett. He was appointed executive director of the Ashbrook Center at Ashland University in 2013 after having worked at Ashbrook for 18 years in various positions. Roger has been pivotal in expanding Ashbrook into a national leader in offering history and civic education programs for students and teachers, and he led the effort to create Ashbrook's Master of Arts degree in American History and Government, both online and at Ashland University, as well as a variety of other programs for middle and high school history teachers to strengthen their understanding of American history and America's founding principles. It's really important to emphasize American history. It's not taught authentically. It's skewed. We got to make sure that folks like Roger Beckett get their say. So I'm really glad he's coming on to talk about this during our first segment today. And then our second segment is going to be with Stephen Motley. He's the president of Less Government, an organization dedicated to less government, including the protecting the First Amendment from governmental assault, writer, television, and radio commentator, political and policy strategist, lecturer, debater, and activist. We love to have on the show. And the topic we're going to be discussing with Seton Motley is we don't need great leaders, but we do need constitutional leaders, because the greatness is really in the Constitution, which is our founding document.
All right. And in our last segment at 4:35, we're going to have Dan Gaynor. He is the Vice President for Business and Culture of the Media Research Center. Dan is a veteran editor with more than two decades' experience in print and online media. And Dan regularly appears on the Fox Business Network, as well as the Conservative Commandos radio show. And Dan is going to be joining us to talk about the networks ignoring Obama's broken promise on cybersecurity in 90% of cyber stories. And, oh, I don't know what a can of worms we got here. And with the internet, it's great when it works. It's a terrific tool, but it must be protected. Doesn't seem like anybody in government is doing it, or
no, they want to regulate everything. And the problem with regulating the internet is it regulates not only speech, but the information that's available to us. And I don't think that that's appropriate under any circumstances. We need to have free reign where it comes to getting the information we need.
Amen. So, Anna, what else is going on, kiddo?
Well, you know, I think at this point we still have to be looking at what's going on internationally. I'm not sure that what's going on with the presidential race is helping us at all. I mean, we've got Hillary Clinton lying through her teeth relative to emails and taking very lightly the situation she's in. I mean, she may very well have disqualified herself as a candidate, but to listen to her, you wouldn't think that. And, you know, that obviously doesn't help us on the world stage. I like to focus on the Ukraine. And in the news, we've got Russia preparing to deploy 50,000 troops to Ukraine. I think it's really a difficult situation we have over there, and I don't think we're paying enough attention to it. I'm referring to a report that is on Infowars.com. So, you know, it's not in the mainstream. But it says the second Ukrainian ceasefire appears to have fallen apart as reports from around the country indicate that heavy fighting has resumed. Mm-hmm. So I guess we better be watching this information. But I think it begs the question, and it should be up to our listeners, who are leaders, movement leaders, to go ahead and reach out to your Congress representatives and especially your senators on this topic. Why are we not supporting our ally Ukraine as Russia takes her over fully? And that is what I believe is underway.
Well, earlier today on Frontiers of Freedom, Hour of Action with George Landreth, George and I were talking about how the Ukraine's military has reported 127 attacks Monday alone by pro-Russian rebels, including an assault by 400 separatists and tanks. 427 attacks on Monday alone. So things are getting heated up over there in the Ukraine, Anna. And Secretary of State John Kerry said he expressed grave concern.
Yeah, and it's about time he started to express concern, because I've got to tell you, this is not a new topic. This has been going on since Russia invaded Crimea, and we did nothing. And what do you expect now? They're going to feel like they have free rein because they waited a good long time for the United States to stand up for our ally, and we have not done so. Mm-hmm. And I know Poland is worried. If the Ukraine falls, Poland is extremely worried. So, I mean, we've got to stand up for our allies, especially those who have followed our example and who have set up democracies as a form of government. And then especially in Ukraine, where they tried to peacefully use that democracy to rule themselves. And it's Russia that's in the wrong here. And we're not standing up for them. We're not doing so in a military sense. We're not even doing so with regard to our media presence on the topic. Mm-hmm. And we're not calling upon our brothers and sisters on the globe to stand up either. That UN is not good for this. It's good for nothing. So I don't understand our approach, and I do think that it's up to we the people to start requiring more attention on this topic.
You know, another thing, another area of concern, Anna, is the Baltic states. They're members of NATO. They have large Russian-speaking minorities, and that's Putin's argument for going into the Ukraine, that NATO has reduced its patrols, its aviation, its aircraft patrols in half. But even with that, it intercepted about 150 Russian bombers and fighters over the Baltic last year. So this is another area of concern, the Baltic states.
You Again. Bring it up, Rick, and you should bring it up, because yeah. back on June 30th of 2015, in the Business Insider, you can find that at businessinsider.com, there is an article entitled, Russia is Reviewing the Legality of Baltic States' Independence.
Wow.
Is that scary or
it
what?
Is.
That goes back to June 30th. And the article, I won't read the whole thing, but I'll give you a little bit. Russia's going to review whether or not it was legal for the Soviet Union to recognize the Baltic states as independent nearly 25 years ago. That's a generation, Rick.
Indeed.
Vladimir Putin wants to turn the clock back.
Yeah.
He wants Russia as an imperialistic communist government like it was. We've got a problem.
Oh, I agree, Anna. And with that, let's take our next break. And you are listening to the Conservative Commandos radio show with Anna Little and Rick Trader. And we're coming to you from the studios of the Conservative Commandos radio network, WNJC 1360 in Philadelphia, and around the world on the internet with our internet broadcast partners, CPR Worldwide Media, Leading Edge Radio Network, TalkStream Live, The Pundit Press, SHR Media, K98 Talk, and AMFM247.com. We appreciate them. Don't go away. Anna and I will be back with our first guest, Roger Beckett. Be right back.
I really don't care. That's my prerogative. They say I'm nasty, but
you've heard Paul Deltz playing the music on the Your Music Matters Morning Show. An experienced mortgage loan officer working for U.S. Mortgage Corporation and assists homeowners navigate the reverse mortgage process. If you are finding yourself asking questions whether or not you set aside enough for retirement, Paul can sit down with you, your family, and your financial advisor and discuss how a reverse mortgage may be a valuable resource for your retirement plan. You will be responsible for paying your taxes and insurance, and the reverse mortgage can help with this and other expenses, such as home health care or other untimely bills. Put Paul's 20-plus years of experience to work for you, as choosing the right option for your situation can be critical. Call Paul at U.S. Mortgage Corporation at 877-213-9977. That's 877-213-9977. Or go to seniormatters.info for more information. U.S. Mortgage Corporation is a licensed mortgage banker in New Jersey, Pennsylvania, and Delaware, and an equal housing lender. NMLS number 3901. U.S. Mortgage Corporation is located at 201 Old Country Road, Suite 140, Melville, New York, 11747. This advertisement applies to first lien mortgages. Paul E. Dilks, NMLS, is 485904.
Hi, this is Bob Vine, owner of Bob's Little Sports Shop in Glassboro, New Jersey. I've had the opportunity to travel in many foreign countries, and I've seen what happens to people when they lose their freedom. I wrote this poem. Give us freedom was the cry as they marched throughout the night at Concord Bridge in Trenton. For freedom they would fight. To build a nation that would last with peace and liberty, it is a job that's never done if we are to be free. They wrote a declaration to announce that we are free, then a constitution for all the world to see. But this is ink on paper. We must make it last. It must always be defended, and that is quite a task. Today the battle rages for freedom in our land. To save our constitution, we all must take a stand. We must stand up for freedom in our actions every day, and you can stand up with us. Join the NRA. This is Bob Biden of Bob's Little Sports Shop in Glassboro, New Jersey. You may call us at area code 856-881-7575 or visit us online at bobslittlesportshop.com.
What does it take to be the leader in production systems technology? To be the one company that solves production problems at any plant, for any product, and with any technology? It takes a 30-year record of success. It takes total mastery of complex technologies with a history of delivering success every time, without fail. Only one company can claim that high ground in manufacturing line optimization, data automation, and systems integration, and that's Philadelphia Control Systems. In factories worldwide, Philadelphia Control Systems programs, software, and engineering solutions deliver optimal performance and output flow with a record that can't be matched. Any plant, any product, any technology. Philadelphia Control Systems, the leader in production automation since 1982. 800-335-9811. PCS for automation.com. That's PCS, the number 4, automation.com.
The Conservative Commandos Radio Show is expanding to become the Conservative Commandos Radio Network. We're establishing a front line of conservative radio broadcasters and ironclad patriots to declare war against the madness of liberalism and the Obama administration. Are you tired as I am about the disregard for our Constitution? Do you still have faith in the American dream? Are you looking for sensible, smart radio? If so, listen to the Conservative Commandos Radio Network every weekday from 11 a.m. to 5 p.m. on WNJC Radio 1360 AM or around the world on the internet at WNJCRadio.com. Check out our websites, ConservativeCommandosRadioNetwork.com and CCRN.com for rebroadcasts and network updates. We are the Conservative Commandos Radio Network, where even more newsmakers go to be heard. From the East Coast to the West Coast and around the world on the internet, we're coming to you live from the CCRS studios, WNJC 1360. This is the Conservative Commandos Radio Show with your host, Rick Trader. The Conservative Commandos Radio Show, where the newsmakers go to be heard. You can call the Conservative Commandos Radio Show at 856-227-1360. Your opinion counts at 856-227-1360.
This is Congressman Alan West, and you're listening to the Conservative Commando Radio Show.
Welcome back, listeners. Welcome back to Conservative Commandos Radio Show with Rick Schrader and Anna Little. If you would like to hear a rebroadcast of today's show, please check out our website, CCRS Network, and CCRShow.com. For mornings at 9 a.m. Standard Time, log on to LeadingEdgeRadioNetwork.com. And now you can listen to Conservative Commandos Radio Show anytime, any day, from any telephone by calling 832-999-1199. We are pleased to welcome our first guest to the Conservative Commandos Radio Show. We have with us this segment Roger Beckett. Roger Beckett was appointed executive director of the Ashbrook Center at Ashland University in 2013. He worked prior at Ashbrook for 18 years in various positions, and he's been pivotal in expanding Ashbrook into a national leader in offering history and civic education programs for students and teachers. Roger Beckett, welcome to the Conservative Commandos Radio Show.
Anna, it's great to be with you. Thank you.
Well, thank you for your work. Why don't we start off by introducing Ashbrook at Ashland University to our listeners so that they can understand exactly what it is you do.
Absolutely. We are an independent center at Ashland University, and we teach constitutional self-government to students and teachers across the country. And we do it with by working with students on developing a better understanding of great books and working with teachers so they can work with their students to understand some of the great documents in American history.
Well, I think that's very, very important because, you know, I am the mother of three young adults, so I've just finished watching and witnessing what they're going through at the hands of educators in the public school system here in my state, which is New Jersey. And I'll tell you, the history they're learning in the classroom is at best watered down, and in some moments, it's actually altered from what I learned when I was in that stage of my education. So it's very important that we have groups like Ashbrook to go ahead and bring us back to the basics of what history really is. Now, you came on the show today to talk to us about what many of today's high school students won't learn, which is the basics of history and government necessary to be informed citizens. Tell us about that.
Well, Anna, that's exactly right. We are about to begin a new school year, and we are unlikely to see any real improvements this year in how American history and civics is taught across this country. If you look at the national test scores, the U.S. Department of Education's report card, the students perform worse in American history and American civics than any other subject. Only 18% of students performed at or above the proficient level in the test scores that they released this year for history, and 23% only scored at that level for civics. So we're doing a pretty poor job of teaching students what it means to be an American, some good things about American history, and unfortunately it's a trend that seems to be only getting worse.
You've told us in this article that there's actually a couple of terms here that have been developing, or maybe one is a term and the others are kind of priorities or themes that are coming out. The first one, which is the term that I've referred to, historiography, I've never heard of it. What is it?
Well, I think what we've seen happen in colleges across the country is a narrowing of the subject of U.S. history. And so we begin to focus at the college level more and more on specialized areas within history, more to try to create historians out of students rather than trying to create citizens. And these things end up trickling down to our elementary and middle and secondary schools. And so teachers there have tended to focus more on some of the narrow parts of U.S. history rather than the broad, important questions that we really have to be looking at if we want to understand more about the story of America.
You know, and it seems to me that when I was growing up, history was where I learned the facts about how this nation was founded, and I got to read the very founding documents, sometimes in combination with other classmates, but we read these documents so that we would know what the founders were thinking and where this country came from and what being an American meant. So when I see that there's this new term, historiography, and I listen to what you're telling me, what I believe is happening is our next generation is being told different things about what it means to be an American, only that there are no document basis for it, and they're either leaving out facts or changing the perspective of those facts. It seems like they're rewriting history. Now, am I being a bit extreme here, or is that what's going on?
Oh, and I think you're exactly right, and I think it's being rewritten left, right, and center. And one of the villains in this whole problem is our textbooks and our overuse of textbooks and over-reliance on textbooks. We have been bequeathed with this incredible history of speeches and letters and documents that tell the story of America. And it gets down to all of the good, hard questions, because, of course, there have been great conflicts in American history and great issues that we have worked through and will continue to work through. And we have some great documents that we can put in front of students that really engage them, that get to the heart of these questions and really pull them into that the story of America, and that's the simple, it's one of the simplest anecdotes to fixing this problem is just to use those documents more and put aside textbooks, and that's what my organization here at Ashbrook does, just help teachers do just that.
Well, I want to thank you for that, and I'm sure our listeners are grateful too. You talk a little bit here about how high school civics courses are placing action over instruction, where they're emphasizing things like volunteerism and democratic engagement, service learning, and the like. Talk to us about that.
Well, you're exactly right. If you look at the typical civics course or government course that is offered across the country, there is a far greater emphasis now on volunteering and doing things in your community than there was 50 years ago. And I'm not saying that doing those sorts of things is a bad thing. Of course, those are wonderful things that we as Americans all do in our communities and in our states. But we can't leave the facts behind. We can't leave the knowledge behind. We have to help kids understand what America is and what she represents in the long history of the world, and how our government works, and probably more importantly, why it works that way. And those are the kinds of things that we really need to return the focus to in the classroom, rather than continuing this momentum toward civic engagement or volunteering or these kinds of activities.
And you also talk about method over matter, talking about the method of teaching more so than being concerned about the content of what's being taught. Can you expound on that a little bit?
Well, absolutely. I said one villain in the story of why we're not doing a very good job of teaching history and civics is textbooks. And I would say the other villain is universities. Most teachers are very good folks who have just been let down by a university and have not been sent out to be well prepared to teach the subject that they're going to be teaching. If we are sending out a teacher out into the world, they've spent too much time on the teaching methods side of things, the education courses, and not enough time on the subject that they need to be teaching. And this is a change that we have to make across the country if we're going to fix this problem, especially for something like U.S. history, which is a really hard topic teach well and to engage students in. And so we really need to return to a greater emphasis on the content that these teachers need to teach.
Well, I think that's I can't agree with you more. And I think that while history can, if presented in a say one-dimensional format, can be kind of dry and difficult to teach, I do think there's an awful lot by way of the theatrical and the artistic to kind of bring it out. And you're right, the content is what matters. So at this point, though, I do need to take us to a station break to identify the station. It's just about 2 minutes. Will you hold on for us?
I'd love to.
Thanks so much. We are speaking with Roger Beckett of the Ashbrook Center at Ashland University, and we are coming to you live from the Conservative Commandos Radio Network studios, WNJC 1360, our flagship station in Philadelphia, and around the world on the Internet with CPRWorldwideMedia.com, Leading Edge Radio Network, TalkStream Live, The Pundit Press, SHR Media, K98 Talk, and AM/FM 24/7, theyareall.com. And now you can listen to our show anytime on our website, CCRS Network and CCRShow.com. We'll be right back with Roger Beckett of the Ashbrook Center after the break.
I really don't care. That's my prerogative. They say I'm messy, but I...
The Conservative Commandos Radio Show is expanding to become the Conservative Commandos Radio Network. We are establishing a front line of conservative radio broadcasters and ironclad patriots to declare war against the madness of liberalism and the Obama administration. Are you tired of the disregard for our Constitution? Do you still have faith in the American dream? Are you looking for sensible, smart radio? If so, listen to the Conservative Commandos Radio Network every weekday from 11 a.m. to 7 p.m. and Saturdays from 2 to 6 p.m. on WNJC Radio, 1360 on your AM dial, or around the world on the Internet at WNJCRadio.com. Check out our website, CCRSNetwork.com, for rebroadcasts and network updates. We are the Conservative Commandos Radio Network, where now even more newsmakers go to be heard.
Hi, this is Bob Vine, owner of Bob's Little Sports Shop in Glassboro, New Jersey. I've had the opportunity to travel in many foreign countries, and I've seen what happens to people when they lose their freedom. I wrote this poem. Give us freedom was the cry as they marched throughout the night at Concord Bridge in Trenton, for freedom they would fight. To build a nation that would last with peace and liberty, it is a job that's never done if we are to be free. They wrote a declaration to announce that we are free, then a constitution for all the world to see. But this is ink on paper. We must make it last. It must always be defended, and that is quite a task. Today, the battle rages for freedom in our land. To save our constitution, we all must take a stand. We must stand up for freedom in our actions every day, and you can stand up with us. Join the NRA. This is Bob Vyden of Bob's Little Sports Shop in Glassboro, New Jersey. You may call us at area code 856-881-7575 or visit us online at bobslittlesportshop.com.
From the East Coast to the West Coast and around the world on the Internet, we're coming to you live from the CCRS studios, WNJC 1360. This is the Conservative Commandos radio show with your host, Rick Trader. The Conservative Commandos radio show, where the newsmakers go to be... You can call the Conservative Commandos radio show at 856-227-1360. Your opinion counts at 856-227-1360.
This is Congressman Alan West, and you're listening to the Conservative Commando radio show.
Welcome back, listeners. Welcome back to Conservative Commandos radio show with Rick Trader and Anna Little. If you would like to hear a rebroadcast of today's show, please check out our websites, CCRS Network and CCRShow.com. Or mornings at 9 a.m. Eastern Standard Time, log on to LeadingEdgeRadioNetwork.com. And now you can listen to Conservative Commandos radio show anytime, any day, from any telephone by calling 832-999-1199. We're speaking this segment with Roger Beckett of the Ashbrook Center at Ashland University. Their focus is on being a national leader in offering history and civic education programs for students and teachers, bringing us back to the basics that have founded this nation and that remind us what it is to be an American. Roger, thank you for holding through that break. We appreciate your time.
And it's great to be with you.
Well, I want to emphasize to you just how very impressed I am with the program that you've described that Ashbrook is offering. I want to give you a chance once again to talk to us. We've talked a little bit prior to the break about historiography, which is what I would call, in layman's terms, the watering down of history, how there's a little bit more focus on action and activism over instruction, which means being a volunteer or a civic leader rather than worrying about the content of our history. And then method over matter, we've got teachers that are coming out, going straight into the classroom, thinking more about the methods of teaching than they are about the subjects they're supposed to be teaching. Tell us what Ashbrook is doing in order to try to improve things or maybe perhaps put back what's being taken out.
Well, I appreciate that. We are working with teachers all across the country because so many folks like to blame teachers for these kinds of problems, and teachers should not be the ones who are blamed. Many teachers know that they need to improve their understanding of American history. There aren't enough opportunities out there available to them to do that, and so that's what we do here. And we have programs ranging from short one-day programs that we offer in schools across the country. We have programs at historic sites where we will go to some place like George Washington's home for a weekend and take a scholar there and study and be on the grounds there at General Washington's home, ranging all the way to a full Master of Arts program in American history and government that's geared toward teachers, that has an unusual schedule geared toward these working professionals, just to try to help them improve their understanding of American history so they can do the same for their students.
I think that just sounds terrific, and I'm really glad that you're here to do that. Thank you for what you're doing. Now, our producer, Rick Trader, had a few questions for you, so I'm going to turn it right to you, Rick.
Yeah, again, we're talking with Roger Beckett. He's the executive director at the Ashbrook Center at Ashland University. Roger, thanks for holding through the break. We appreciate your time. Roger, I love history. Going through school, I was not a very good student, but my favorite subject was history. And I think part of that is because that I had teachers that also loved history and loved, especially loved the history of our country. How important is that?
Oh, I think it's absolutely critical. I mean, the best teachers that I ever had in school were the ones who knew their subject well, and they loved what they taught. Mm-hmm. And you could see that in the first 10 minutes of any class. It's immediately apparent to somebody. And so many teachers that go into American history do love the subject, mm-hmm. but they're not given enough of a background to really tie things together for their students, and that's largely what we try to do here, to help give a that broad perspective of American government and American history to these teachers, not only to improve their understanding, but help improve their appreciation of it as well.
You know, Roger, you and Anna were talking about civics, and to me, civics is a word that's lost. And I wonder, in what percentage of schools or in high schools is civics taught today?
Well, it certainly is on the decline. It varies across the country from state to state, and of course varies often within each state. But there's no question that the teaching of these interesting questions about America, that, you know, about the Constitution, about the arguments over the Constitution, that's not taking place any longer. In the last history test scores that the U.S. Department of Education released as their nation's report card, only 8% of students could give a reason why students would or why citizens would have voted at the time to ratify the Constitution, vote against ratification. Only 8% of students, and these are questions that are really fundamental to the idea of self-government going forward. If we're going to be a self-governing people, we need to understand where this thing was founded and what the questions that they worked through to get us to this point.
Here on the Conservative Commandos radio show, we're talking with Roger Beckett. He's the executive director of the Ashbrook Center at Ashland University. And we're talking about what many of today's high school students will not learn. Roger, I know we're talking about high schools, but I wanted to tell you a story that I myself witnessed. It was several years ago in my other job. I am a videographer, and I was hired to videotape a candidate who was announcing their run for Congress. And after the announcement, it was time for questions and discussion. And the topic turned to, why isn't the Constitution being taught in schools today? And during that conversation, there was one particular lady who was getting upset. And she stood up and she blurted out, she says, "I just want you to know, I'm a third grade teacher. I teach the Constitution in my classroom. But to do so, I have to close my doors so the administration and other faculty members don't know what I'm teaching." Why is that, Roger Beckett? Why are teachers afraid to teach the Constitution today?
Well, it's obviously unfortunately become a partisan issue, and it shouldn't be. The Constitution is not something that should be a partisan question, and I think most citizens are very strongly supportive of our Constitution and the idea of constitutional self-government. But if you go back to the progressives and the changes that they sought to make in America, they were certainly trying to minimize the role of the Constitution. The Constitution limits powers. I mean, that was the great miracle of the founders. They declared themselves free. Then the first thing they did was they set down to limit their own powers. An extraordinary act of humility. And if you would like to have a more energetic federal government, you don't like the idea of limited power. So the Constitution, to an extent, certainly has unfortunately become a bit of a partisan document. But I think Americans are still pretty broadly supportive of the idea of the Constitution and self-government under that Constitution. So we need to keep on teaching it.
I totally agree. Roger, we have a couple of minutes, but I also wanted to tell you why I would never be elected to a school board. Because come President's Day, come Memorial Day, come Martin Luther Day, it would not be a day off for kids to run through the shopping malls. They would be in school learning about the presidents, learning about the sacrifices that our men and women and arms have made. They'd be in school learning about what Martin Luther King meant and stood for. That's why we'd not be elected to school board.
Well, it's going to be hard to stop July 4th from being a national holiday.
Well, I didn't include the 4th of July in that.
So we have a month away from now, Constitution Day.
Hey, Roger, please tell us where people could go to find out more about the Ashbrook Center and Ashland University and what you do there.
Absolutely. We're online at ashbrook.org, A-S-H-B-R-O-O-K, and we have a website that's geared toward teachers and students to provide great resources for them. It's a Teaching American History website, and people can go to it at TAH.org, teachingamericanhistory.org, either one work.
Roger Beckett, Executive Director of the Ashbrook Center at Ashland University. I want to thank you so much for joining us on the Conservative Commandos Radio Show.
Well, Rick and Anna, it's been a real delight. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much for joining us. And we are going to take a break, and you are listening to the Conservative Commandos Radio Show with Anna Little and Rick. And we are coming to you from the studios of the Conservative Commandos Radio Network, WNJC 1360. And around the world on the internet with our internet broadcast partners, CPR Worldwide Media, Leading Edge Radio Network, TalkStream Live, The Punnett Press, SHR Media, K98 Talk, and AMFM 24/7. They're all .com. A couple other .coms for you. Our websites, CCRShow.com and CCRSNetwork.com, where you can find out about all the great conservative programming here at WNJC. We'll be right back.
You've heard Paul Deltz playing the music on the Your Music Matters Morning Show. He is also an experienced mortgage loan officer working for U.S. Mortgage Corporation and assists homeowners navigate the reverse mortgage process. If you are finding yourself asking questions whether or not you set aside enough for retirement, Paul can sit down with you, your family, and your financial advisor and discuss how a reverse mortgage may be a valuable resource for your retirement plan. You will be responsible for paying your taxes and insurance, and the reverse mortgage can help with this and other expenses, such as home health care or other untimely bills. Put Paul's 20-plus years of experience to work for you, as choosing the right option for your situation can be critical. Call Paul at U.S. Mortgage Corporation at 877-213-9977. That's 877-213-9977. Or go to seniormatters.info for more information. U.S. Mortgage Corporation is a licensed mortgage banker in New Jersey, Pennsylvania, and Delaware, and an equal housing lender. NMLS number 3901. U.S. Mortgage Corporation is located at 201 Old Country Road, Suite 140, Melville, New York, 11747. This advertisement applies to first lien mortgages. Paul E. Dilks, NMLS, is 485-904.
Hi, this is Bob Vine, owner of Bob's Sports Shop in Glassboro, New Jersey. I've had the opportunity to travel in many foreign countries, and I've seen what happens to people when they lose their freedom. I wrote this poem. Give us freedom was the cry as they marched throughout the night at Concord Bridge in Trenton. For freedom they would fight. To build a nation that would last with peace and liberty, it is a job that's never done if we are to be free. They wrote a declaration to announce that we are free, then a constitution for all the world to see. But this is ink on paper. We must make it last. It must always be defended, and that is quite a task. Today the battle rages for freedom in our land. To save our constitution, we all must take a stand. We must stand up for freedom in our actions every day, and you can stand up with us. Join the NRA. This is Bob Biden of Bob's Little Sports Shop in Glassboro, New Jersey. You may call us at area code 856-881-7575 or visit at bobslittlesportshop.com.
What does it take to be the leader in production systems technology, to be the one company that solves production problems at any plant, for any product, and with any technology? It takes a 30-year record of success. It takes total mastery of complex technologies with a history of delivering success every time, without fail. Only one company can claim that high ground in manufacturing line optimization, data automation, and systems integration, and that's Philadelphia Control Systems. In factories worldwide, Philadelphia Control Systems programs, software, and engineering solutions deliver optimal performance and output flow with a record that can't be matched. Any plant, any product, any technology. Philadelphia Control Systems, the leader in production automation since 1982. 800-335-9811. PCSforAutomation.com. That's PCS, the number 4, automation.com.
The Conservative Commandos Radio Show is expanding to become the Conservative Commandos Radio Network. We're establishing a front line of conservative radio broadcasters and ironclad patriots to declare war against the madness of liberalism and the Obama administration. Are you tired, as I am, about the disregard for our Constitution? Do you still have faith in the American dream? Are you looking for sensible, smart radio? If so, listen to the Conservative Commandos Radio Network every weekday from 11 a.m. to 5 p.m. on WNJC Radio 1360 AM or around the world on the internet at WNJCRadio.com. Check out our websites, ConservativeCommandosRadioNetwork.com and CCRN.com, for rebroadcasts and network updates. We are the Conservative Commandos Radio Network, where even more newsmakers go to be heard. From the East Coast to the West Coast and around the world on the internet, we're coming to you live from the CCRS studios, WNJC 1360. This is the Conservative Commandos Radio Show with your host, Rick Trader. The Conservative Commandos Radio Show, where the newsmakers go to be heard. You can call the Conservative Commandos Radio Show at 856-227-1360. Your opinion counts at 856-227-1360.
This is Congressman Alan West, and you're listening to the Conservative Commando Radio Show.
Welcome back, listeners. Welcome back to Conservative Commandos Radio Show with Rick Trader and Anna Little. If you would like to hear a rebroadcast of today's show, you can check out our websites. They're CCRS Network and CCRShow.com. Or mornings at 9 a.m., you can log on to LeadingEdgeRadioNetwork.com. And now you can listen to Conservative Commandos Radio Show anytime, any day, from any telephone by calling 832-999-1199. This segment, we are very pleased to be speaking with Seton Motley. Seton Motley is president of Less Government, which is an organization dedicated to, well, less government. That includes protecting the First Amendment from governmental assault. Seton Motley is a writer, a television and radio commentator, political and policy strategist, a lecturer, a debater, and an activist. Seton, welcome back to Conservative Commandos Radio Show.
Thank you very much for having me. How are you?
I'm doing great. Thanks so much for all you do.
Thank you very much. I appreciate that.
Yep, and I am so glad that you are coming on to Conservative Commandos today to talk to us about, we don't need great leaders, we need constitutional ones. Tell me what you mean by that.
Well, there's a, everybody knows, or most people know, the Lord Acton saying, power corrupts, and absolute power corrupts absolutely. But they forget the next sentence in the phrase, which was, great men are almost always bad men. And what we've seen throughout the course of this nation's history, certainly in the last 100-plus years, is people trying to engender the great label via government expansion. There's no man, woman, or child who enters government, unfortunately, that doesn't seem to feel the need to aggrandize themselves by creating their little niche of greatness in the history of American government. And it happens in niches, it happens in the regulatory agencies, I mean, it's everywhere. And you don't, you know, we'll start with the judiciary. The judiciary is, you don't have a historic or landmark decision by continuing 230 years of jurisprudence. You don't. You have an historic or landmark or great decision when you upend 230 years of jurisprudence. The example I thought of was the homosexual marriage decision, where they managed to create out of whole cloth a right to homosexual marriage in the Constitution. And it was historic because, of course, there is no such right. There is no such enumerated power for the federal government to do this. And it was historic because they made it up out of whole cloth and upended 230 years of jurisprudence. The executive branch does it all the time. All the agencies, departments, commissions, and boards. The EPA is a particularly pernicious one. Their historic, you know, power climate change regulations. Well, they're historic because they've gone further than they've ever gone before. But what everyone has to remember is, every executive branch agency is actually a creation and a creature of Congress. They can't do anything unless and until Congress writes a law saying, hey, EPA, do this. That's never happened in those regards. The example I looked at specifically is the Federal Communications Commission. In an historic decision, the three Democrats at the FCC, unelected bureaucrats, decided to unilaterally impose 1934 monopoly landline telephone and railroad law onto the Internet. Now, Congress has never written the words to do that, but the FCC did it anyway. The three Democrats voted yes, the two Republicans voted no. So that's historic. That's great. Well, there's all sorts of regulations and taxes that now empowers the FCC to impose. But fear not, they tell us, the three Democrats tell us, we will practice a legal term called forbearance. And what forbearance says is we will apply some of the taxes and regulations, but not all. Now, I doubt seriously that they won't apply more than they're saying currently, but let's take them at their word and say that they are. Say that they're happy enough with their place in history, with their D.C. greatness, by unilaterally imposing 1934 monopoly law onto the Internet, as far as they want their legacy to go. Well, they're bureaucrats that are on a term limit, and they won't be there forever. And what about their successors? Their successors come in with a greatness rating, a legacy rating of zero. They haven't done anything yet. So if you're telling me with all those taxes and regulations waiting to be imposed on the Internet that are just laying there, that the successors to these three Democrats won't impose it to get their slice of great, to make their mark in the arc to tyranny of the history of the United States, I'm dubious.
Well, I think that you're smart to be dubious, because I don't think there's a tax that a government has ever, I don't think a government has ever found a tax that it didn't like. Obviously, the government doesn't increase revenue without taxing us, because the government has no money unless we give it to them. So on the issue of taxes, I think you're 100% right. If the tax exists, it's going to be charged. And if they feel, if the people responsible for voting those taxes into existence feel the need to tell you that they're going to somehow defer the imposition of those taxes, they know they've done something that you don't like. And remember, I guess you agree with me, but listeners, you need to remember, it's not the government official that's in charge. They serve at our pleasure. And the problem we have with this executive branch, and I'm going to give you a chance, Pete, to talk about this some more, is that these folks are appointed, they're not elected, and Congress isn't reining them in. Talk to me about the responsibility of Congress here and what they're not doing that they should
right.
be doing.
As I said, every executive branch agency is actually a creation of Congress. And they can't do anything. There's a reason, one of the reasons Congress writes laws is because it establishes the parameters within which the regulatory agencies are then supposed to operate. Now, we're in a bad situation here with this power grab because Congress has never written any law. So the FCC is taking upon itself to regulate the Internet. And because there's no law that authorizes them to do that, there's no stopping them as to how far they can go. Because they're off the map already. You know, out here there'd be monsters. They've created this at a whole cost. Now, there are, I think, 10 different associations or companies that are in the process of suing the FCC for what they did. Court hearings have been announced. They're going to be December 4th is when the court date starts. But in the meantime, these rules and regulations are in place. And they're very constricting. And again, you're right. The Senate approved the five commissioners on the FCC, three of the president's party, two of the opposing party. So this is what we get to, and this is, you know, I like Ted Cruz an awful lot, but when he says we should have retention elections for Supreme Court justices, that's absurd. The Founding Fathers already built a check and balance into the system. It's called the advise and consent rule. If a Sotomayor or an Elena Kagan comes before the Senate, they have no business being on the Supreme Court, and the advise and consent power allows the Senate to prevent them from being on the Supreme Court. To try to fix it after the fact is too late.
I love your analysis of this. We are not done with you yet, but we do have to take a short break to identify the station. 2 minutes, please hold on.
No problem, thank you.
Okay, we are coming to you live from the Conservative Commandos Radio Network studios, WNJC 1360, our flagship station in Philadelphia and around the world on the Internet with CPR Worldwide Media, Leading Edge Radio Network, Offstream Live, The Pundit Press, SHR Media, K98 Talk, and AMFM 24/7. They are all .com. You can listen to Conservative Commandos anytime on our website, CCRS Network and CCRShow.com. We will be right back with Seton Motley after the break.
They say I'm crazy. I really don't care. That's my prerogative. They say I'm nasty, but I.
The Conservative Commandos Radio Show is expanding to become the Conservative Commandos Radio Network. We are establishing a front line of conservative radio broadcasters and ironclad patriots to declare war against the madness of liberalism and the Obama administration. Are you tired of the disregard for our Constitution? Do you still have faith in the American dream? Are you looking for sensible, smart radio? If so, listen to the Conservative Commandos Radio Network every weekday from 11 a.m. to 7 p.m. and Saturdays from 2 to 6 p.m. on WNJC Radio, 1360 on or around the world on the Internet at WNJCRadio.com. Check out our website, CCRSNetwork.com, for rebroadcasts and network updates. We are the Conservative Commandos Radio Network, where now even more newsmakers go to be heard.
Hi, this is Bob Vine, owner of Bob's Little Sports Shop in Glassboro, New Jersey. I've had the opportunity to travel in many foreign countries, and I've seen what happens to people when they lose their freedom. I wrote this poem. Give us freedom was the cry as they marched throughout the night at Concord Bridge in Trenton. For freedom they would fight. To build a nation that would last with peace and liberty, it is a job that's never done if we are to be free. They wrote a declaration to announce that we are free, then a constitution for all the world to see. But this is ink on paper. We must make it last. It must always be defended, and that is quite a task. Today the battle rages for freedom in our land. To save our constitution, we all must take a stand. We must stand up for freedom in our actions every day, and you can stand up with us. Join the NRA. This is Bob Vyden of Bob's Little Sports Shop in Glassboro, New Jersey. You may call us at area code 856-881-7575 or visit us online at bobslittlesportshop.com.
From the East Coast to the West Coast and around the world on the Internet, we're coming to you live from the CCRS studios, WNJC 1360. This is the Conservative Commandos Radio Show with your host,
Rick Trader, the Conservative Commandos Radio Show, where the newsmakers go to be heard. Businessman there, drink my wine. You can call the Conservative Commandos Radio Show at 856-227-1360. Your opinion counts at 856-227-1360.
This is Congressman Alan West, and you're listening to the Conservative Commando Radio Show.
Welcome back, listeners. Welcome back to Conservative Commando's Radio Show with Rick Trader and Anna Little. If you would like to hear a rebroadcast of today's show, please check out our website, CCRS Network and CCRShow.com. For mornings at 9 a.m. Eastern Standard Time, log on to LeadingEdgeRadioNetwork.com. And now you can listen to Commando's Radio Show anytime, any day, from any telephone by calling 832-999-1199. We are speaking this segment with Seton Motley, president of Less Government, and we are talking about how we don't need great leaders, we need constitutional ones. And Seton, just before the break, you were getting me awfully excited when you were talking to us about the role of Congress when it comes to these administrative agencies that have appointed leadership and they're confirmed by the Senate, but their powers are not necessarily defined. And we're talking right now, I guess, about the FCC primarily because of some recent events. So why don't you pick up where you left off there?
Yeah, well, just like the judges and justices, the five commissioners on the Supreme Court, well, I mean, on the Federal Communications Commission, the FCC, one of whom also was the chairman, all approved by the Senate. And it's almost always this pro forma thing. Now, it's very difficult for me to imagine. Look, the FCC has already tried twice to impose what's called network neutrality, which is socialism for the Internet. It guarantees everyone equal amounts of nothing. Twice, the D.C. Circuit Court has unanimously said there's never been a law written to authorize you to do that. So, therefore, we're throwing it out. So they already did it twice. Now, since they've done it twice, we've gotten a new Democrat chairman at the FCC, and we've gotten a new Democrat commissioner approved to the FCC. My question would be, if I were a senator on the relevant committee in the Senate, at the approval hearings of these people, say, net neutrality has already been thrown out twice. Are you going to finally leave it alone? But apparently nobody asked that, and if they did, it didn't sway enough senators to vote no on either one of these people, because they both voted yes in February on this new power grab. Now, this is the new power grab, just to be clear, is net neutrality on steroids. Again, they've applied 1934 monopoly law for landline telephones and railroads to the Internet. Now, they did that to power grab enough authority, allegedly, to then justify imposing net. But this is a huge power grab, and why is Congress not defunding them? Why aren't they passing a bill that says the FCC cannot spend a penny on enacting their net neutrality, their Title II power grab? They're not doing any of this. They're doing none of this. We've got pseudo votes on defunding Planned Parenthood and Obamacare, defunding Obamacare and repealing Obamacare. Meanwhile, the Export-Import Bank has died, and Republicans in the House and Senate are actively working to resurrect it. There's a bit of a problem and a disconnect there.
Yep, that sounds to me like a pretty good analysis of where we are, and I think, you know, we need to take some lessons from this and stand up and get our representatives to straighten up and fly right, you know, do the job and follow the will of the people. But I know...
What amazes me is, again, all these executive branch agencies are stealing power
right.
That's supposed to be Congress's. One of the things the founding fathers counted on was that each branch would jealously guard their respective authorities. Congress
right.
isn't doing that. My
right.
favorite example was, after the 2014 election, I believe, or maybe the 2012, anyway, Democrat Sheila Jackson Lee from Houston, Texas, one of the poster children for gerrymandering, announced that she would put together a committee of congressmen to write executive orders for Barack Obama. So they're signing up to help the president steal their power from them and do their job unilaterally rather than going through the legislative process.
I think we have to get back to making the election about a representative that will take the voice of the people, the government, not have the government take away the power of the people. But with that, I want to let my producer chime in. Rick, take it away.
Yeah, here on the Conservative Commandos radio show, we're speaking with Seton Motley, who's the president of Less Government. And I love having Seton on because I love saying Less Government. And Seton, I want to thank you for joining us, and we're discussing your article, We Don't Need Great Leaders, We Need Constitutional Ones. Seton, in your article, you wrote a couple of lines that jumped out at me. You talk about Ben Franklin, and there's this famous where a lady asked Ben Franklin what kind of government that they gave us, and they said, a republic if you can keep it. And you say, we have failed to keep it because too many have done too much constitutional violence in their attempt to be great. Another line I want to connect the two. But all three branches are populated by mere men and women, too many of whom are seeking to be great. The judicial branch, far too often, instead of going constitutional, goes for ever bigger government. Seton, do you think that these people feel that they need to make their mark in history? Is it an ego thing, Seton?
Well, I kind of view it as kind of the anti-ego thing. I've always viewed leftists as nerds in high school who got picked on and never got over it. Now, don't get me wrong, I was 5'6" my senior year in high school. I got picked on, I'm now 6'5". That's a separate issue. But they never got over it. And the real world has not treated them very well. So they go to use government to enact vengeance on the real world. And it's not just hardcore leftists that do this. I point you to exhibits A and B, Mitch McConnell and John Boehner. Please pardon this, but it's true. These people are yutzes. They would never have acquired this much power and influence in the real world. But here they are in Washington as Speaker of the House and Senate Majority Leader, and they're enacting their vengeance for being them on the real world via government. And that's part of what it is. It's bigger government as therapy, and it makes them feel better. And it may make them look better inside the Beltway, but it's awful for the rest of us.
Seton, can a leader be great by following the Constitution, or is that just not sexy?
Well, that's the thing. You're not being historic if you adhere to the system. Mm-hmm. You're not making a mark if you adhere to the system. That's one of the... post on Red State, I put a picture with a quote of Calvin Coolidge. Because Calvin Coolidge was Silent Cal. He understood it. He's a caretaker. One of his famous lines is, the business of America is business. He understood that a great leader is one who gets out of the way of the Constitution and allows America and Americans to be great.
I wonder how many Americans know who Calvin Coolidge even is.
Well, unfortunately, we've had 60 years of government school and no one does. But for people who don't know, Ronald Reagan, when he moved into the Oval Office as president, the first picture he hung was of Calvin Coolidge. Mm-hmm. So, if that gives you any, perspective. Calvin Coolidge actually shrank government. It actually spent less on his last year in office than it did his first. It not slowed the rate of growth. It was actually dollar for dollar less. And he understood that. He understood that the role of elected officials is to let the system work. Get out of the way of the Constitution. Let ordinary Americans do extraordinary things. He did it. It was fabulous. That's why you've heard the term Roaring Twenties. Mm-hmm. That was Calvin Coolidge.
Why do you think they've gotten away with this?
Well, it's a harmonic convergence. I mean, we've lost, we as conservatives have lost just about every, field of endeavor in the United States. The left runs the government schools, primary and secondary. The left runs the colleges and universities. The left runs the news outlets. The left runs the entertainment outlets. The left runs everything. And after 30 or 40 or 50 or 60 years, look, people are inherently conservative.
Yeah.
To be trained to be otherwise. But with every training apparatus in the hands of the left, after 50 or 60 years, you get there. Look, America is not any more or less stupid than they were 60 years ago.
Hey, we only have about a minute left. I wanted to ask you your opinion on one more thing. Then I'd like you to tell our audience where they could learn more about less government. I have a feeling it's because we have full-time professional politicians who have to justify their existence. So they look for every stinking way to do that.
Well, look, it's again, these people hate the real world. So they become career politicians to escape the real world.
Probably so.
Look at Joe Biden. He actually got elected, was constitutionally eligible to be elected at the age of 30 in the Senate.
Wow.
But he was sworn in at the age of 30. He was elected at 29. I think he has a November or December birthday. He turned 30 before he was sworn in. And he's been in government his whole stinking life. Harry Reid.
Seton Motley, because we're short on time,
tell
our audience about Less Government, where they can go to get...
Lessgovernment.org. Go sign up for the email list, and we'll send you all our stuff as we write it.
Seton Motley, thank you for joining us today on the Conservative Commandos Radio Show.
Always a pleasure. Thank you, guys.
Take care. And we are going to take a break. You are listening to the Conservative Commandos Radio Show with Anna Little and Rick Trader. Coming to you live from the studios of the Conservative Commandos Radio Network, WNJC 1360, and around the world on the internet. Everybody wants to know why I read this list all the time, because we appreciate our internet broadcast partners, such as CPR Worldwide Media, Leading Edge Radio Network, TalkStream Live, The Pundit Press, SHR Media, K98 Talk, and AMFM247.com. Don't go away. We'll be right back with our next guest, Dan Gaynor from the Media Resource Center.
You've heard Paul Deltz playing the music on the Your Music Matters Morning Show. He is also an experienced mortgage loan officer working for U.S. Mortgage Corporation and assists homeowners navigate the reverse mortgage process. If you are finding yourself asking questions whether or not you set aside enough for retirement, Paul can sit down with you, your family, and your financial advisor and discuss how a reverse mortgage may be a valuable resource for your retirement plan. You will be responsible for paying your taxes and insurance, and the reverse mortgage can help with this and other expenses, such as home health care or other untimely bills. Put Paul's 20-plus years of experience to work for you, as choosing the right option for your situation can be critical. Call Paul at U.S. Mortgage Corporation at 877-213-9977. That's 877-213-9977. Or go to seniormatters.info for more information. U.S. Mortgage Corporation is a licensed mortgage banker in New Jersey, Pennsylvania, and Delaware, and an equal housing lender. NMLS number 3901. U.S. Mortgage Corporation is located at 201 Old Country Road, Suite 140, Melville, New York, 11747. This advertisement applies to first lien mortgages. Paul E. Dilks, NMLS, is 485-904.
Hi, this is Bob Vine, owner of Bonzel's Sports Shop in Glassboro, New Jersey. I've had the opportunity to travel in many foreign countries, and I've seen what happens to people when they lose their freedom. I wrote this poem. Freedom was the cry as they marched throughout the night at Concord Bridge in Trenton. For freedom they would fight. To build a nation that would last with peace and liberty, it is a job that's never done if we are to be free. They wrote a declaration to announce that we are free, then a constitution for all the world to see. But this is ink on paper. We must make it last. It must always be defended, and that is quite a task. Today the battle rages for freedom in our land. To save our constitution, we all must take a stand. We must stand up for freedom in our actions every day, and you can stand up with us. Join the NRA. This is Bob Biden of Bob's Little Sports Shop in Glassboro, New Jersey. You may call us at area code 856-881-7575 or visit us online at bobslittlesportshop.com.
What does it take to be the leader in production systems technology, to be the one company that solves production problems at any plant, for any product, and with any technology? It takes a 30-year record of success. It takes total mastery of complex technologies with a history of delivering success every time, without fail. Only one company can claim that high ground in manufacturing line optimization, data automation, and systems integration, and that's Philadelphia Control Systems. In factories worldwide, Philadelphia Control Systems programs, software, and engineering solutions deliver optimal performance and output flow with a record that can't be matched. Any plant, any product, any technology. Philadelphia Control Systems, the leader in production automation since 1982. 800-335-9811. PCS4automation.com. That's PCS, the number 4, automation.com.
The Conservative Commandos Radio Show is expanding to become the Conservative Commandos Radio Network. We're establishing a front line of conservative radio broadcasters and ironclad patriots to declare war against the madness of liberalism and the Obama administration. Are you tired as I am about the disregard for our Constitution? Do you still have faith in the American dream? Are you looking for sensible, smart radio? If so, listen to the Conservative Commandos Radio Network every weekday from 11 a.m. to 5 p.m. on WNJC Radio 1360 AM or around the world on the internet at WNJCRadio.com. Check out our websites, ConservativeCommandosRadioNetwork.com and CCRN.com. Rebroadcasts and network updates. We are the Conservative Commandos Radio Network, where even more newsmakers go to be heard. From the East Coast to the West Coast and around the world on the internet, we're coming to you live from the CCRS studios, WNJC 1360. This is the Conservative Commandos Radio Show with your host, Rick Trader. The Conservative Commandos Radio Show, where the newsmakers go to be heard. You can call the Conservative Commandos Radio Show at 856-227-1360. Your opinion counts at 856-227-1360.
This is Congressman Alan West, and you're listening to the Conservative Commando Radio Show.
Welcome back to the Conservative Commandos Radio Show with Anna Little and yours truly, Rick Trader. If you'd like to hear rebroadcasts of our shows, check out our website, ccrshow.com or ccrsnetwork.com, or mornings at 9 a.m. Eastern, log on to leadingedgeradionetwork.com. But you could also hear our show from your telephone by calling 832-999-1199. And our next guest is with us, Dan Gaynor. He is the Vice President for Business and Culture of the Media Research Center. Dan is a veteran editor with more than two decades experience in print and online media. Dan, as well as a regular here on the Conservative Commando Radio Show, regularly appears on Fox Business Network. Dan, welcome back.
It's a pleasure to be back. How are you guys today?
We are doing fine, thank you, and it's great to have you with us. We've asked you to join us today to talk about an article that was written on the by the Media Research Center, Joseph Rozell. Networks ignore Obama's broken promises on cybersecurity in 90% of cyber stories. And Joseph starts his article by saying, the Obama administration has managed cybersecurity so poorly, Secretary of State John Kerry has admitted to CBS that it is, quote, very likely the and Chinese are reading his emails.
You would think that would be big news, wouldn't you?
I would think so.
Just somehow or another, you know, that this is a national crisis. I get stunned sometimes by how the, you know, remember back, go back to 2008 when Obama, you know, said cybersecurity would, you know, be a top priority as president. We couldn't afford another president who didn't understand the threats that confront us now and in the future.
Well, Dan,
pretty sure he doesn't understand.
I don't think so, Dan. And this is a pretty big problem. Also in the article, Joseph says that the Chinese government stole the detailed records of nearly 22 million people, including former and current federal employees and nearly everyone who has ever applied for security clearance. So they're not targeting Mary Soapsuds, who is getting a credit card at Walmart. I mean, they are targeting government officials.
And then also IRS got hacked. It's you know, that number's up to 334,000 different IRS accounts. I mean, you know, we're under attack, constant attack on the cyber front. And 9 out of 10 stories, they don't even remind you that Obama said this was going to be a big deal. And now that it's clearly and grotesquely a failure, oh, yeah, we're not going to bother talking about that. Why would we do that? That's that would make him look bad. We like him.
Well, maybe there's a good reason that Hillary Clinton had her server in the bathroom of some little computer shop somewhere in Colorado. But apparently, Dan,
But isn't that just an amazing story that I mean, how is no one in prison right now for the Hillary, you know, email scandal? Why aren't the media asking that question? Why hasn't everybody been brought in by the government? I mean, everybody involved. Everybody who works for Platte River, which I think was the company. Everybody, you know, who's handling security at her place, her lawyer. Everybody who's had the chain of evidence here. Everybody involved, like, well, by the way, we're locking up. We're going to figure out what's going on. Oh, you released, you know, well, fine, you're going to prison. Oh, you can't do it. Yes, actually, we can. National security. That's the way they would handle it if you and I did this.
Well, that's how they handled it back in the Watergate days, Dan. But we don't have a media today. And Joseph points it out in this article that, you know, we don't have a media today, Dan, that is even bringing this up. Joseph writes, broadcast news protects the president and his administration on cybersecurity issues by refusing to criticize the administration in 90% of cybercrime stories. 90%, Dan, of 154 stories about this, in 139, they're protecting the administration.
Yeah, and I mean, this is not a minor thing. This is tens of millions of people affected. You know, everybody, top secret clearance. The Chinese know everything about them. Everything. I mean, you know, have you ever done one of those top secret clearance questions?
No, I haven't.
I've been the reference for a couple people who have been up for top secret clearance. And they ask detailed personal stuff. And that doesn't count the personal forms you've got to fill out when you're applying. This is the entire livelihoods of these people, their credit records, their personal accounts, their dark secrets.
Well, Dan, do we have any examples where the Chinese or the Russians or anyone else has used this information?
Well, I mean, the thing is, we're not likely to know.
Okay.
I mean, that's for all we know, they might be using it every day.
Mm-hmm.
Or they might be blackmailing some people. I mean, that's a lot of people. There's no way in the world the government can monitor 22 million people.
Mm-hmm. Well, Dan, I'm sorry.
So how do you know that spies are not reaching out to some of the people they think are potential targets on this list, saying, hey, you know, we know about your, and fill in the blank, whatever freakhood is revealed by their top secret clearance. We know about this. We're going to reveal it unless you help us.
Well, we don't know. You're right about that. We do not know. Joseph also writes in the article, despite the failures, the network rarely direct blame towards anyone in the Obama administration. I would say that about cybersecurity or anything else, that the media, especially the broadcast media, is obviously on the side of this administration.
Yeah, overwhelmingly so. And to the point, you know, when they do ask tough questions, you're stunned. I think you look at it when Pelley was talking to John Kerry the other night. I mean, it's like, oh wow, we're getting a couple tough questions. But not enough. I mean, there's no accountability. I mean, that's what it comes down to. When the Bush administration was around, Bush was blamed for everything. Obama's around, he's blamed for nothing.
Mm-hmm.
When Harry S. Truman was in the White House, he used to say the buck stops here. The buck stops everywhere but the Oval Office now with this media.
Well, you certainly could see, I can remember how Nixon and the Nixon administration was treated by the media during the days of Watergate. Of course, that's when we had a real, when we had journalists doing their job to ferret out these stories that we don't have it today. But it goes beyond the media not doing the job, Dan. It's the media is protecting this administration.
Well, yeah, I mean, we had the media doing the job, but remember, the media were doing the job to take down a Republican president.
Okay.
So they were perhaps more engaged in that job. When we had problems with Bill Clinton, now that we have problems with Barack Obama, the media weren't especially engaged. Mm-hmm. They didn't want to take down those presidents. What they learned from the Nixon era is a lot of journalists went into the field not just to become journalists, but to take down a Republican president.
Mm-hmm. Austin shares a story. He talks about Obama attempted to keep his promises through various initiatives. He appointed his first cybersecurity coordinator, in other words, a cybersecurity czar, signed an executive order in creating the Cyber Threat Intelligence Integration Center with an annual budget of $30. Is $35 million, is that enough, Dan? For a problem?
Considering whether it's the credit card hacks or the government hacks or the server problem, we're dealing with a technological infrastructure that is several generations behind what a lot of private companies are doing. IRS has repeatedly tried to upgrade its systems and failed. I mean, the fact that we can have a Secretary of State in this country running her email off her own server and nobody noticing and stopping it is astonishing.
Hey, Dan, we got to take a quick 2-minute break. Could you hold on for us, please?
I can indeed.
All right, you are listening to the Conservative Commandos Radio Show with Anna Little and Rick Trader, coming to you live from the studios of the Conservative Commandos Radio Network, WNJC 1360, and around the world on the internet with CPR Worldwide Media, Leading Edge Radio Network, TalkStream Live, The Pundit Press, SHR Media, K98 Talk, and AMFM247.com. Please check out our website, ccrshow.com and ccrsnetwork.com. We're speaking with Dan Gaynor from the Media Research Center, talking about Obama's broken promise on cybersecurity. Be right back.
The Conservative Commandos Radio Show is expanding to become the Conservative Commandos Radio Network. We are establishing a front line of conservative radio broadcasters and ironclad patriots to declare war against the madness of liberalism and the Obama administration. Are you tired of the disregard for our Constitution? Do you still have faith in the American dream? Are you looking for sensible, smart radio? If so, listen to the Conservative Commandos Radio Network every weekday from 11 a.m. to 7 p.m. and Saturdays from 2 to 6 p.m. on WNJC Radio, 1360 on your AM dial. or around the world on the internet at WNJCRadio.com. Check out our website, CCRSnetwork.com, for rebroadcasts and network updates. We are the Conservative Commandos Radio Network, where now even more newsmakers go to be heard.
Hi, this is Bob Vine, owner of Bob's Little Sports Shop in Glassboro, New Jersey. I've had the honor of traveling in many foreign countries, and I've seen what happens to people when they lose their freedom. I wrote this poem. Give us freedom was the cry as they marched throughout the night at Concord Bridge in Trenton. For freedom they would fight. To build a nation that would last with peace and liberty, it is a job that's never done if we are to be free. They wrote a declaration to announce that we are free, then a constitution for all the world to see. But this is ink on paper. We must make it last. It must always be defended, and that is quite a task. Today the battle rages for freedom in our land. To save our constitution, we all must take a stand. We must stand up for freedom in our actions every day, and you can stand up with us. Join the NRA. This is Bob Vidin of Bob's Little Sports Shop in Glassboro, New Jersey. You may call us at area code 856-881-7575 or visit us online at bobslittlesportshop.com.
From the East Coast to the West Coast and around the world on the internet, we're coming to you live from the CCRS studios, WNJC 1360. This is the Conservative Commandos Radio Show with your host, Rick Trader. The Conservative Commandos Radio Show, where the newsmakers go to be heard. You can call the Conservative Commandos Radio Show at 856-227-1360. Your opinion counts at 856-227-1360.
This is Congressman Alan West, and you're listening to the Conservative Commando Radio Show.
Welcome back to the Conservative Commandos Radio Show, and you can hear rebroadcasts and podcasts of our shows by checking out our website, ccrshow.com or ccrsnetwork.com, or mornings at 9 a.m. Eastern, log on to leadingedgeradionetwork.com. But you could also hear our show from your telephone by calling 832-999-1199. And we're speaking with Dan Gaynor. He's the Vice President for Culture and of Business and Culture at the Media Research Center. And we're discussing the networks ignore Obama's broken promise on cybersecurity. Thanks for holding through that break, Dan. We appreciate your time.
Well, thank you. I mean, you know, this is simple. If you're listening at home, it is. Here's a quote from Obama's 2015 State of the Union Address. No foreign nation, no hacker should be able to shut down our networks, steal our trade secrets, or invade the privacy of American families, especially our kids. And, you know, and he said something similar back in 2008, where he, you know, talked about make cybersecurity the top priority that it should be in the 21st century. Well, since that, even since his 2015 State of the Union, we've had 22 million records stolen from the Chinese. The IRS has been hacked. We've had this litany of server problems and interruptions, and we're under constant cyber war from Russia and China especially, but North Korea as well. And the media don't want to draw the connection.
Dan, is there any difference between the broadcast media in reporting this and the print media?
Well, the thing always about print media is they have more room, so they'll cover more stuff. You know, it's when you do a 2-minute piece in broadcast networks, sometimes 250, 300 words, mm-hmm. but a news story end up being 700, 800 words. Mm-hmm. So they might include some criticisms of that. I also think the print media understand the cyber war a little bit better than broadcast media, which seems odd since broadcast media is more technology. But yes, it seems like print media get it a little bit better. Mm-hmm. But still, it's the same media. They don't want to beat up Obama and make him look bad.
Well, you know, earlier, Dan, you and I were talking about the annual budget of $35 million that Intelligence Integration Center has been given. Also in Joseph's column, and we're referring to a column written by Joseph Rozelle of the Media Research Center. Networks ignore Obama's broken promise on cybersecurity in 90% of cyber stories. That CNN reported that Russian identity thieves who hacked the IRS, stole the tax returns of 104,000 Americans, a theft worth $50 million. But only $35 million have been allocated to fight this problem.
And like I said, and then you look the today's USA Today, the front page of the money section from this morning, IRS hack three times in thought. So even that story. So it's now 334,000 people involved. And, you know, I mean, how deep does it go? How deep do all these? Does anybody feel that any of their information is kept safe? I don't.
I'm leery of giving my identification. You know what gets me, Dan? You go anywhere today. They want... I'll tell you a story, Dan. Just last week, I tried to check into a hotel in Richmond, Virginia, that I had prepaid for. And they want photo ID when you check in to the hotel. I gave them my U.S. passport. You know, they refused to accept it as identification. They refused to accept my U.S. passport. What they wanted, Dan, was my driver's license with my address on it, my date of birth, my driver's license number. You go to a doctor today, they want your Social Security number. They want photo ID. God knows where this stuff goes, Dan, and who can get access to it.
Well, apparently anybody but us.
Apparently. Well, this is the reason.
It's like, okay, I want to find some missing files. Maybe I'll just contact a Russian hacker or a Chinese hacker. They probably have it. I mean, we should be asking them for Hillary Clinton's emails.
Well, they might have them. I would be surprised if they didn't have them, Dan.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yep.
Dan, what's it going to take? What's it going to take for the American public or the media to wake up? I mean, how big of a problem is this going to be?
This is an enormous problem. The media don't want to cover it because it makes a liberal administration look bad. If it were Republican administration, they'd be like, oh, look how backward they are. Oh, they're not up to snuff. I mean, this is supposedly the smart, cool kids. They can't even run a website selling health care. So why the heck should we expect that they can fend off cyber criminals?
Yeah. Joseph also makes another great point in this article. He says the Chinese could use this information to recruit spies in the United States. And he's quoting retired General Michael Hayden, former director of the CIA and the NSA.
Spies, people that they blackmail. I mean, we're in a cold war against both China and Russia now. And, to allow them just to access our technology and our files willy-nilly without trying to stop them is useless.
Dan Gaynor, I want to thank you for joining us on the Conservative Commandos radio show.
Thank you very much. You guys have a great day.
Well, Dan, tell our audience where they could go to get more information.
You can always find us at newsbusters.org, and I also write for foxnews.com.
All right. Dan Gaynor, thank you so much for joining us. Take care. God bless. All right. And I do want to remind you all out there to please check out our websites, ccrshow.com or ccrsnetwork.com. That talks about all the great new conservative program here at WNJC 1360, starting at 12 noon with The Edge of Liberty with Sean Lewis. Then at 1 and 2 o'clock, we have a rotating schedule of conservative programming, each different program every day. At 3 p.m. Eastern each day, we're right here at the Conservative Commandos radio show. And then at 5 o'clock, we have either rebroadcasts of our shows or we have fresh programming. So check out that website, CCR. CCRSnetwork.com, CCRSnetwork.com. I want to thank you for sitting in today as my audience. But for right now, we're out of time. We got to run. We got to go. Take care. God bless. We'll see you tomorrow on the radio. And stay tuned for the Edwards Notebook.
Once again, liberal bigotry rears its ugly head. Hello, I'm Ron Edwards. On today's page from the Edwards Notebook, as of now, if you are a Christian high school graduate and are considering a higher education, just beware that the Community College of Baltimore has joined the growing list of American colleges and universities that openly discriminate against Christians. No more is it just the dirty look or a snide remark, but as Mather Clark of the American Center for Law and Justice put it, public colleges and universities are taking the gloves off when it comes to Christian students on their college campi. Christian students can now expect applications to be rejected if they let it be known that they are a person of faith. Now, if you are a unnatural sexual practitioner or a major with America and all non-Muslims, hey, no problem. You get to the head of the class. One Christian student, Brandon Jenkins, was flat out rejected at the Community College of Baltimore after honestly answering an admission interview question, what was the most important thing in his life? To which young Brandon answered, my God. Thus, he was quickly told, this is no place for religion. Funny thing, though, bigoted campus liberals didn't refuse any Muslim students strolling around. Gee, I wonder why. I'm Ron Edwards.
The leader in talk radio on the internet, right here on K98Talk.com.
When our water heater broke down last month, it was a nightmare. It took 5 hours for the plumber to show up, and he charged us a couple of $100 just to come out. Then it cost another $1,800 to put in the new water heater. By the time it was all said and done, I felt like I'd been taken. But what else could I do?
The smartest thing you can do is get a home warranty from American Residential Warranty. Their home warranties pay to repair or replace all your major appliances when they break, and they will break, and at the worst possible time. Call American Residential Warranty right now for free information on home warranties starting at just pennies a day. Don't wait for your refrigerator to stop running or your ceiling fans to stop turning. Call American Residential Warranty right now. Ask how you can save up to 50% on water washer and dryer coverage. Just call 1-800-513-6154. That's 1-800-513-6154. Again, 1-800-513-6154. Call now.
Tired of paying outrageous prices for Viagra? Well, we have great news for you. Now you can finally get Viagra at huge discounts. Healthy Man allows you to save up to $500 on Viagra. Why pay U.S. pharmacy prices of $15 per pill or more when you can get Viagra for less than $3 a pill? Call today and get 40 Viagra pills for only $99. This can cost as much as $600 at your local pharmacy. You can't afford not to call us. If you want Viagra at the lowest prices, never pay $15 a pill pharmacy prices again. Get Viagra for less than $3 a pill. Call 1-800-516-7602 today and save up to $500 and get 40 pills for just $99. Healthy Man is fast, easy, and affordable. Operators are waiting at 1-800-516-7602 to take your call right now. Call 1-800-516-7602. That's 1-800-516-7602. Again, 1-800-516-7602.